As the U.S. finds itself in a new strategic environment where it has to counter surging China, along with its old but resurgent rival Russia, the U.S. Navy has released a vision document about its next-generation strike fighter. The U.S. Navy has provided several details about the future F/A-XX fighter that will replace the F/A-18, E, and F Super Hornet in the 2030s. The new details and artwork related to the F/A-XX program, among other things, were contained within an unclassified document titled Navy Aviation Vision 2030 to 2035, which the service released now. F/A-XX dates back to at least 2012 and is now part of the U.S. Navy's larger Next Generation Air Dominance NGAD effort. As the Super Hornets are retired from service, a combination of F-35C and F/A-XX will ensure carrier-based power projection capabilities and maintain relevance in complex threat environments. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how the U.S. Navy Next Generation Strike Fighter will look like. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by War Thunder, the most comprehensive military vehicle online game for PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One, in which you can go to battle on more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s. The game has an amazing attention to detail and focuses on a realistic combat experience, which is why knowing your vehicles and skill really makes a difference. It's easy to get into, and all you need to play is nothing more but your mouse and keyboard or controller. Immerse yourself in cross-platform combat with more than 20 million other military vehicle enthusiasts from all over the world. Download and play War Thunder for free using the link in the description below, and also get a free bonus tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account. The new F/A-XX artwork, which only shows a top-down view, depicts a design with a broad, almost Lambda wing shape and canard foreplanes. Reports suggest that aircraft may have rudder Vader tailplanes, similar in broad strokes to the ones found on Northrop's YF-23 stealth fighter. YF-23 was the design that ultimately lost out to Lockheed Martin's YF-22, which was later designated as the F-22 Raptor. Several reports have suggested that the YF-23 has even better stealth characteristics than the Raptor. It's to be noted that there's no guarantee that the exact design is being developed, and this can only be an indicative depiction. It's unlikely that the U.S. Navy would disclose an actual advanced aircraft design in this kind of unclassified document, but it can be very well gauged that the design will incorporate stealth features and high maneuverability. The Boeing MQ-25 Stingray is an aerial refueling drone that resulted from the Carrier-Based Aerial Refueling System, CBARS, program, which grew out of the earlier Unmanned Carrier Launched Airborne Surveillance and Strike, U-Class, program. In October 2017, U.S. Navy released the final MQ-25 Stingray RFP. The competitors were Lockheed Martin, Boeing, Northrop Grumman, and General Atomics. Boeing came into the competition with a full-fledged prototype derived from its Phantom Ray demonstrator, which ultimately won. Stingray is seen as a major force multiplier and is compatible with the current crop of carrier-based aircraft like the F/A-18 E and F Super Hornet, F-35C, and E-2D Hawkeye. The next generation fighter is also expected to work with Stingray. U.S. Navy has indicated that the F/A-XX is being developed so that it can be armed with longer range weapons, including future hypersonic missiles. The idea is to further extend the standoff reach of these planes. Hypersonic weapons are the ones that can exceed the speeds of Mach 5, that's 5 times the speed of sound. There's no reliable defense against these presently, and the new fighter will certainly see the incorporation of this type of weapon. For long-range engagement, more powerful sensors will also be added. The new crop of sensors will also ensure significant improvement in overall situational awareness. U.S. Navy wants the FAXX to be able to control a group of unmanned aircraft carrying munitions equipped with electronic warfare suites. This is in line of the Loyal Wingman Initiative. The ultimate goal is to pair manned fighters with unmanned versions of older jets in order to boost the lethality of both in air combat. The Loyal Wingman technology gives the human pilot, in a mixed manned-unmanned section, the ability to issue general commands to the pilotless plane, attack, joint formation, etc. This has been possible due to new computer algorithms to allow fighter pilots to control armed drones from inside their own cockpits. U.S. Navy has stated that it wants FAXX aircraft to fly farther and faster than the existing Super Hornet. This is an area that will obviously see a lot of focus. The idea is that the new fighter will be able to reach the battle zone in a shortened time span, and also the carrier can launch them from a greater range. This will increase the operational flexibility to a great extent. The greater range of the aircraft will enable the U.S. Navy to keep the carrier outside the strike envelopes of rivals, reducing the risk factor. FAXX will be compatible with the U.S. Navy's secretive new electronic warfare ecosystem known as Netted Emulation of Multi-Element Signature Against Integrated Sensors, or NEMESIS. The new electronic warfare system of systems has been clandestinely refined over the last 5 years. The Advanced Electronic Warfare Program uses swarms in the air and sea to cooperatively fool a wide variety of sensors. These realistic-looking false signatures and decoys have the ability to appear simultaneously across disparate and geographically separated enemy sensor systems located both above and below the ocean surface. This will ensure the fighter acts as a node in the larger scheme of things. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.